Game show coordinator Don Patrillo is on a mission to interview the last couple of the evening.
We enjoy traveling.
In fact, Bobo, why don't you get the lights?
Wrong.
Good idea.
No, not a good idea. Wait.
Alaska Highway, 1966.
Shut it off.
Little did he know that his brief stop at the home of Howard and Bobo O'Dell would turn out to be the longest night of his life.
End of story. I'm out of here.
To show him the shotgun.
The Roth Company presents an experiential film like no other.
She struck my body a full blow. The side of my face hit the tree, which was just behind me. And she said, "Take me."
You are going to hell for such a lie.
The New York Times did not say, "Vacation Survivors is a unique movie-going experience that transcends the normal and delves into the bizarre."
What do you mean that's it? You said people thought you were fooling around. And then you said, which we weren't. And then you said, not yet.
Correct.
So when was it?
What?
The fooling around. When was the fooling around?
Oh, that's another story. But we know.
The Chicago Tribune did not say, "Vacation Survivors test your ability to multitask through its audio and visual tapestry. If you don't drink now, this movie may certainly drive you in that direction. It's whacked."
Never ever take a fat guy on a hike.
However, Tom Stevenson of the Dallas Chronicle did say, "Vacation Survivors is a journey into creative filmmaking."
You think I'm stupid, don't you? I know what you're doing.
Join Don Patrillo on his journey through Howard and Bobo's vacation films and strange tales of adventure, lust, espionage, and human survival.
Queen's coronation?
1953. I was there with some friends.
And you did see the parade?
I not only saw the parade, Mr. Patrillo, I was in the parade.
Yeah, right. In the parade.
It's a vacation you'll never forget.
It really doesn't matter. I mean, the Queen saw me.